In the next 10 minutes, we'll be talking about this picture by Rembrandt depicting a woman bathing in a stream. And we will be looking at what the picture might actually depict and how the story that is possibly conveyed in this picture actually relates to the sitter in, or the person who is depicted in the painting. And we'll also be looking at why this Rembrandt is such a beautiful painting and why it is one of the most popular Rembrandts in the National Gallery. And well, there it is behind me. It's a magical picture. It is actually a very peculiar painting. It's an unusual one. The sizes, it's not a large painting. It's not very small either, but it's not your usual size Rembrandt painting. It's very intimate. There is this woman bathing through a stream. There is something about this. We're not quite sure what's going on. And I think it's fair to say that it has a definite erotic undertones, the way that she wades through the stream and lifts her garment. So why is this such a famous Rembrandt, and why is it such a popular Rembrandt? It is, I think, partly because it is so incredibly beautifully painted, and we'll get onto that later on. And partly, I think, because we don't quite know what is going on in this picture. So it's very intriguing. The first question one might ask is, who are we actually looking at? And it's fairly certain that the woman that Rembrandt was living with at that time when he painted this, and this is 1654, and there are good reasons to believe that it is her. And she was living with Rembrandt at the time, but they were not married, and this is important to keep in mind. Really, the question is there actually more to this picture than that? Is there a story in this painting? And there has been much discussion about that, and I'm not going to pretend I'm going to give you the final word here on that, but I'm going to suggest that one of the things that have been suggested, which I think is quite an elegant solution, again, I'm not going to say it's the correct one, but it's an elegant one, where it is suggested that perhaps here Hendrickje is actually posing as Callisto. Now, Callisto was one of the nymphs that would accompany Diana, goddess of the hunt. And indeed, in the most famous depictions of that, you will see Diana accompanied by her her nymphs, usually by a stream or something like that, and they're wading through it. And that's the usual iconography of Diana and her nymphs, and one of the nymphs is Callisto. Now, Callisto, she would have to be chased, and this is the story as we know it from Ovid's Metamorphoses. And of course, there's always something going on there, and you can rest assured that Jupiter, of course, manages to seduce Callisto, and indeed she becomes pregnant, and eventually this is discovered. Now, you would perhaps wonder, what has that to do with this picture? And the interesting thing here is that in 17th century Holland, there was another version of this story of Ovid that was retold, as it were, in the Dutch language. And in that story, Callisto is not so much punished in that way, but she is sent to the wilderness. And that's where she spent a lot of her time. And now we're getting to what we're sort of seeing in this picture. And so that is, in a way, her punishment. And it is not inconceivable at all that that is the story that Rembrandt actually knew at the time. Now, why would he depict his companion in such a way? You might as well ask. And it's a very fair question, and we can't say for certain that it is true. But it so happens that in 1654, when this picture was painted, Hendrickje was actually summoned to the church council. She was admonished for living with a man without having married him. And as a consequence, she was banished from Holy Communion at the church. And that was a big thing in those days. And there was no denying it. And she had to be, you know, she was there from henceforth excluded from Holy Communion. Now, it's from there that you can take the step, as it were, from how Callisto would have been banished in the story to the wilderness, in the Dutch version of the story, and how, in this case, Hendrickje indeed may have been banished from her usual life, as it were, and could not participate in Holy Communion in the church. You could argue, I leave it to you as the viewer to see what you think of that, whether that is a possibility, but it would at least explain why this picture looks the way it does, because it does look unusual. Why would you have someone bathing in a stream like that, at that size? And you feel like you have to come up with a solution that explains this particular iconography. But of course, this picture is not just about what it depicts. I think its glory is really how it's done. And if we look close at the picture and we start looking into how the brush has been handled, it is absolutely astonishing. There is a surety of touch there that is quite unbelievable. And it is almost as if Rembrandt is drawing in paint. It's almost a little bit like a sketch in that sense. All the brush strokes are done quite quickly and quite quickly set onto the work. And there's no working out of details at any great length. You can see it beautifully in her garment, for example, which is really just quite sort of forceful strokes. And yet the whole thing makes sense. That garment really hangs from her torso, has weight, and then she holds it up, of course. And I think one of the most beautiful details in the picture is where you can, if you look at her right hand and the way she pulls up her what she's wearing, that hand is a little miracle all by itself. It really is only about three, maybe four brush strokes, very quickly done. A little bit of black, just to model the fingers and the hand. And it is done so quickly and so absolutely on the money. There's that hand is a hand, if ever there was a hand. And the way it holds up her garment is phenomenally well characterized. And as I said, it is almost like a painting, you know, that is a drawing or a drawing in paint, however you want to put it. And it does indeed remind you of Rembrandt, who was, of course, a fabulous draftsman, how his drawings look. And there is a beautiful example, and it also almost certainly depicts Hendrickje, an example in the British Museum here in London. It's a famous drawing. Again, it's Hendrickje, and in this, she's just sort of asleep. And she's lying sort of on her side a little bit. And again, you see there her hand done with brush and ink in very quick, that's even more shorthand than is the case here. Really maybe two or three very quick strokes, and there her hand is absolutely perfectly characterized in that drawing. And so, you know, what happens there in a drawing is essentially happening here in a painting, and I think that accounts for that explains why this picture is so popular and why it is indeed so beautiful. I mean, if you ask me, it's perhaps even the most beautiful. Some people would say it's the most beautiful Rembrandt we have. Some people even think it's the most beautiful Rembrandt, or even the most beautiful picture in the National Gallery. And I think that is why this is such a magical picture and why it is so very popular. If you want to learn more about art history, you can click either here or here. Thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you next time.